writers and readers, welcome back to my channel. My name is Elizabeth, and today we're going to be going over my bullet journal setup for December. Now, I know you'll be seeing this a little bit later in the month, and so it'll be a little bit off timing. Hopefully, I'll do it earlier next month. We'll do a planner lineup for 2022, and I'm super excited for that as well. So stick around and subscribe to my channel if you do like my content and want to see more of that. But today we're going to specifically show you my December setup for this month, and I mainly use bullet journaling for tracking my time and habits. So there's a lot of writer and readerly stuff in this month, so I can't wait to go ahead and show you. So I'm just going to explain briefly what everything is, because I go through it fairly quickly to set up because I didn't have much time and I had been procrastinating it for like a week. So here's my monthly spread. I do really simplistic Bujo setups, so here they are. Right now you're looking at my tasks and time tracking system. I do a daily time tracking system, so I have blocks set out, and if you want to learn more about that, let me know in the comments. But I'm still figuring it out a little bit, but I think it's going a lot better than other time tracking systems I've had, and I can't wait to work on it more. And in this Bujo, I also have other trackers specifically related to author and reader stuff, so we're gonna get to that in just a second here as soon as I finish up these dailies and tasks. So this is my sleep tracker. In those dotted lines is where I sleep ideally. And then over there's my water tracker, and I don't show it much, but it's to see the amount of water I'm drinking per day. So these are little habits now that I want to perform, and in each of these boxes I'm gonna use a marker to mark off when I did those things. And it's hopefully gonna work fairly decently. I have a whole page for journals, that's how many journals I have. So I have an anxiety tracker here to mark what my anxiety was that day, and I had a whole key set out. So this is my author tracker, and I have a whole bunch of stuff out for when I want to post or when I worked on a specific project or things like that, and I'm pretty excited to use that one. So this is my goals page, and it's going to help me look forward to the future and see what I want. Now, this wellness page is specifically one of the reasons I did a bullet journal, was to work on my health and mental health. Now, this is my reading tracker, and I'm pretty excited about this one. I think I'll show you a little bit here how it's supposed to work, because I don't know if I could explain it quite here, but it each has my book and then the days I read that book, as well as the start date, the end date, and the pages I read, length of time I read. And I have many books that I can show you on here as well that I have worked on. So this is my quarterly part in the back here, and I haven't started this yet, but I should really get started on my quarterly planning for the new year. And so I just literally have laid out my quarterly goals. So now I'm just decorating throughout. Because it's very simplistic and I didn't really have time to do art, I'm just using washi tape and stickers. Don't mind the messiness of it, but I thought it worked out pretty good for being thrown on there quickly. I'm pretty happy with all my trackers, and I'm hoping that they work well. As you see here, I'm color coding my anxiety key, so that I can be a little bit more specific, I suppose, and then a journaling page over there to help. And this is just the finishing pages here, and then I am almost done. So that was the full setup. I'm going to show you quick the reader trackers and the writer trackers and kind of how they're going to work for me. So up here, I already have written out some goals. So I want to finish these books, and I want to have a good book rotation and routine. So that kind of applies because I read so many books at once, to make sure that I get all of them in the rotation and kind of make sure that I'm reading the right amount of each one, or kind of seeing where I'm spending most of my time. So each of these, I'm just going to briefly explain it a little bit. So this is the book title. Now you could decorate this with art or something, but because I was short on time, I just decided to do a very simple cover. This is the start and end date. So I started like December 5th and I'm still reading it, so I don't have an end date yet, but this is like my other trackers that I was explaining. So I'm going to put a marker dot when I complete reading for that day. So over here beside it, we have the date I read, how many minutes I read, and how many pages I managed to read in that length of time. And I don't know if I'm gonna have enough space here. I'm just kind of playing with this. This isn't fully set yet. And it kind of goes through that way. And I started Raven Boys, well, the Raven Boys in October. I don't know exactly what date. So that's a mystery. But I kind of go through, I also didn't write a date for these guys because I've been reading them for a lot longer, so I don't remember. This one over here, I started in October. I started a lot of books in October, guys. I went on a book shopping spree. Not the best decision. So currently I have several books that I am reading, so I think it's 9 in total that I've put into this book tracker. Up here I've written the most for it because I've been really into reading The Stolen Kingdom by Bethany Atizadas. I will link her YouTube channel down below. She is an AuthorTuber here on YouTube, and her book's been great so far. I'm really enjoying it and looking forward to reading the rest of the series. Now let me show you the author trackers. Alright guys, so this is my author tracker. So like I said, these are just simple trackers that you can mark off with a marker what days I did them, so that I can see my consistency and where I need to improve for the new year. So like when I posted or did Instagram stories, or when I uploaded a video here on YouTube, or when I wrote for Soul Chaser. And I have other writing projects here, but I'm not going to release the titles of them. One of them, you know, is Project Angel, and the other one is a co-author project. So I'm not going to release the titles for that, but I'm pretty excited about these two projects as well. So those are my author trackers and reading trackers. Alright guys, thank you for setting up my December 2021 bullet journal with me. Let me know in the comments down below if you use bullet journals and if you like using yours. I'm fairly new to it, so I'm just learning on the go. Alright, please do subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you'll be notified when I put out new videos, and I will see you next week with a planner lineup as well as some other little tidbits for the new year. Alright, bye guys!